Welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. Today I'll be talking about the process of creation, or you can say cosmogenesis, from the student's point of view. So today episode will be for the students, for the youngsters who want to know what is creation, who has created this existence, this whole existence. Or is there any creator, or there is no creator, as Stephen Hawking says. Now, I would like to say to all the students and to all the youngsters that now scientists started talking about consciousness. Whenever they talk about creation, they talk about consciousness nowadays. For the past 5 years, they have been talking about consciousness. Now, according to the scientist, modern scientist, theoretical physicist and physicist, they say consciousness is the ultimate reality of this existence. Consciousness has a role in the creation of things, in the creation of this whole Brahmanda, this whole existence. So, now, we have been talking about this consciousness, this element, from time immemorial, the yogic science. The yogic science propounded by Patanjali, Kapil Muni and so many others, they also have been talking about consciousness. Their term for consciousness is chetana, chetan. Now, from the yogic science point of view, how the world is created, the whole universe is created. Now they say there are basically three principles in order to create this whole universe. The first principle is the pure consciousness. Pure consciousness means what? Pure consciousness means the consciousness which is free, which is not identified, which is alone. That is pure consciousness, pure energy. Now, this is the first principle. In this pure consciousness, there is pure primordial matter also. So actually, in the beginning, I should not say in the beginning because there is no sense of time. But just for the sake of saying it, I am saying there are two principles. One is pure consciousness and the other principle is pure primordial matter. Pure in the sense that both are unidentified from each other. Consciousness, pure consciousness does not know anything else. And in primordial matter, there is no sense of anything else. So primordial matter is pure and pure consciousness is also pure. Both are pure and both are unmanifested because there is no space and there is no time in those two principles. So the first principle is pure consciousness, and in the pure consciousness there is pure primordial matter. Now, when pure consciousness get identified with the primordial matter which is in it. In other words, we can say that if pure consciousness observe the primordial matter, then in the primordial matter there occurs or there arises the third principle. What arises in the third principle? When pure consciousness observe, there is an observation of pure consciousness for the primordial matter. In the primordial matter, there are multiple, you can say, something which is the combination of both consciousness and matter. Means consciousness and something which is unconscious. These are multiple. These are of many types. In Hindu philosophy and in many other religions, okay, they are also called jivatmas. So the first principle is pure consciousness, chetan. Second principle is primordial matter, which is in pure consciousness. This is the second principle, which is also called prakriti. And the third principle, which arises by the combination of pure consciousness and pure primordial matter, there are multiple jivatmas. Now these are the three principles. In theosophy, the third principle, which we are calling jivatmas, multiple jivatmas, multiple types of jivatmas, they call them monads, right? So from these three principles, everything is created. Now till these three principles, there is no creation, because there is no sense of time or space. Now let's go further. Now these monads, these jivatmas, when they develop, by and by, when they develop the sense of individuality or the sense of higher ego or the sense of me or asmita, according to Hindu doctrines, asmita. Asmita means the sense of me, the sense of I. When this individuality comes into being, the jivatma becomes able to create something out of it. Right? So one jivatma can attract many other jivatmas so that they can form or they can take on a particular shape or a particular entity. Right? So in this way, they start creating something. Now, once these jivatmas and these monads develop a sense of I, then from here, from this sense of I, the cosmic energy is created. This cosmic energy is the main driving force of or behind the creation of everything in this universe. So cosmic energy is created by these individualized monads, right, which is created from the combination of first principle, that is pure consciousness, and the second principle, that is pure primordial matter. So these are the fundamentals in order to understand the whole fabric, the whole framework of this cosmos, of this Brahmand, you can say, right? So if you think about it, if you look at it very, very deeply, you just be aware of these things, and by you can get to the core of how things are created, what different principles are involved in anything. Now these three principles are involved in each and every entity. To a subatomic particle also, for example electron or quarks, you will find these three principles, or scientists will be able to find the presence of these three principles, right? The pure consciousness, pure primordial matter, and the combination of these two, that is jivatma or monads. Thank you.